Hey, what's up, folks? How you doing? Box. What's in the box? What's in the box? Well, I'll tell you what's in the box. This is my brand new seat for my 1977 KZ650 race bike. In previous videos, I mentioned a company called Texavina. I will put their link down below. They made the seat for my 1979 KZ750 Twin. And if you don't know already, that was the first seat they ever made for that model bike. So those twins were from 76 to 79. The B1 through the B4, B like B. And they never made those seats for those twins before. They did for the 80 and up. So in contacting Texavina, Tex, the owner, said, sure, we can make that seat for you. They did. It was fantastic. It's been on that bike for almost 4 years now. Oh, maybe three. And comfortable, well-made, has held up so far wonderfully well. So and it ends up that they have been using photos of my KZ750 Twin as their advertising, which I'm pretty proud of, I will say. But I reached out to Tex and said, hey Tex, since I'm helping you guys out with my photos and you're advertising your seats, maybe you can help me out because I need to buy a seat for the KZ650, and they had a seat I really liked that they make. And he said, sure, so he offered me a bit of a discount. So thank you, Tex, very much. Now, that being said, this is not sponsored. I paid for this myself. The rest of the amazing news is that conversation and this order took place on June 11th of 2022. It is now June 27th of 2022. So that is 16 days. It was 16 days from placing the order, and this shipped out from their factory or manufacturing premises in Vietnam. So all the way from Vietnam, made, sent, and got here in 16 days. I'm very happy about that. Again, way to go, Tex and company. So it's just arrived. I want to unbox it for you. That being said, too, I'm a little nervous because the three times I've tried doing unboxing videos on my channel, what was in the box was bad or wrong or had a problem. I don't think that will be the case now. Let's break that negative streak right now. So I will unbox it with you, and let's see what we've got. All right, I crossed out my valid info because people are weird. America. So I'm gonna carefully cut this open one-handed because I've got you guys with me. Now, I definitely have to be careful not to puncture anything or cut the seat, right? Let's see if I can do this. There we go. There we go. I don't know if you saw any of that. That's okay. You know what knives and tape look like. I can't believe it. Yeah, I'm a big fan of these seats. I highly recommend them for anybody looking for a seat for their vintage bikes. They're so well made, and even more so, the seat pans. They give you a brand new seat pan, which is steel, which is powder coated black, and which has all of the screw holes that are threaded, spots for whatever bumpers your seat has, what have you. Sorry, I'm trying to navigate this box whilst talking to you. Oh, top. So yeah, that's pretty amazing, and they're all at a really good price. I will say the shipping costs are a little ouch. I think it was about $75 for shipping, but again, totally worth it. And you won't be upset. It's worth it. Do I got it? Yeah, look at that. I hope it's not full of popcorn. I just cleaned the house because I'm having guests. Let's see. Dun, 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 dun. Da, 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 da. All right, well packaged. Got just the right amount of styrofoam. Oh, a little tape there. America. Let's get that tape off. This whole one-handed thing is tricky. A little more tape. I don't want to use the knife anymore. Wow. Did we, I'm sorry. I know, I'm like right in your face. But did we break the curse? Okay, it's black. Okay, yes, checkered stitching. I really like that. Don't you like that? And then finally, look at this, folks. Look. Oh, this is a plastic seat pan. It's supposed to be metal. I don't mind so much, but, oh, maybe it is. Maybe it's not plastic. I might be wrong. It feels like plastic. It sounds like plastic. I'm gonna have to ask him, but this is welded on, so it can't be plastic. All right, my mistake, I take it back, rewind. So look, bumpers already installed. This is, that bike has a hinge with a latch, so the seat stays up, that's installed. Whatever screw holes, that's where my hardware, you use the original hardware from your original seat. That's not there. I'll see if it fell out or if it might not need it, but let's look at this. My goodness, it's got a long tail on it because I'm keeping the tail on the bike, so I like it. I wish this was a little more, see how it's a gradual curve? I wish it was a little more squared off, but it still looks dang good, and I think it'll be more comfortable racing on this than on the seat that's already on the bike. Plus it'll make it a little bit more my own. I've never had a seat with a diamond pattern like this. Another thing about Texavina, they have a variety of colors for the material. They've got brown, they've got black, and then you can choose the color of the stitching too. So this stitching can be a variety of colors to match your bike. I'm just a big fan of theirs. Look at that. Look at that seat. Okay, gonna pause for a moment and then we'll go into the garage and see what it looks like on the bike. Woohoo! First things first, that one missing bumper was in the packaging, so way to go, Texavina, yet again. I just have it sitting on the bike on top of the other seat, but doesn't that look awesome? Look at it. I think that's gonna just look real smart when it's installed. Plus it's a little lower in the seating area than the stock seat, so I'll be a little closer with to getting my feet on the ground, so I'm happy about that. Here, I wanna show you this too. So, if I unlock the seat, so you can see under here, all of the attachment points, like that is that. You got the four places for the hinges. You got the two screw holes for the schmopper. Yeah, the only thing I see that's missing is, although this hole is here, put the rubber grommet in, like right there, the two screw holes, that's like a document holder. Those are missing. Now, for me, that doesn't matter because I'm going to be racing. I don't need documents in there. But for other folks, maybe that's an issue. So I'll let Tex know. Well, I guess I can call him Tex now because we have a thing going. And I'm going to send him pictures of this bike when the bike is all put back together and polished up a little with my race numbers on it. So he can take a look at those photos too and maybe use those. So yeah, there you have it. Really, really happy with this. And I'm going to put it back in the packaging for now. And when I have a chance, I will put it on the bike. And I will show you when I'm done. Well, there you have it. What do you think? Isn't it nice? Beautiful. I didn't bother showing swapping over the hardware just because it's pretty self-explanatory. But I'll show you now that it's done. So I basically just put the original hinges into the new seat pan. It did come with new bolts. the original latching part for the latch, I put that in. This thing just needed some slight modification. This part is actually a separate piece on the original seat. It's built into this seat. It had a like a hitch pin type keeper. You couldn't put that in because it was hitting, so I just put in a very teeny tiny baby cotter pin. Sorry, my brain is phasing out. But yeah, that's like the little hinge thing that keeps it up. And then you take it out. It's a little snugger fitting, but works just fine. It's locked. There you have it. The only thing, I think I mentioned earlier that the original seat has a little flap thing here that you can put documents under. The hole is here for the rubber part that it would clip into, but not the two holes for the other side of it. Interestingly enough, those are 6mm headed bolts, which was the same for here. And here this is welded on, and here the holes are not drilled. So I'm wondering if they're having troubles drilling and tapping those little bolts. Just a guess. Anyway, there you have it. Put the bumper in. And yeah, it feels good. It looks good. I'm really happy with it. Functions well. I think it gives the bike the look I prefer. It's a little softer than the seat on my KZ750 Twin. I just love this pattern. Never had a seat like that before. Anyway, there you go. Texavina.com. I will put their link down below. Hope you like their stuff. If you do buy anything from them, tell them Constantine sent you. Who knows? Maybe I'll become their spokesmodel.